Good. All right. Good evening. Good night, everyone. Thank you for your patience. Obviously, draft's always a long night. We were wrapping up a couple things, hopefully for your benefit, so I can talk about some more. So first, just want to thank my front office. It's the draft is always a culmination of not just weeks and months, but really years of work. Our guys hitting the scouting trail and scouting these guys, preparing for a long time. So Wes Wilcox, amazing job. Phil Jabor, who really runs our entire draft process. Paul Johnson, the rest of our scouting department, our analytics group. Unbelievable job by those guys. Obviously going into tonight, a little different position than last year, which is a good thing. And I hope a lot of that in the future. I think the same thing that we're always looking to do, which is use the draft, free agency, trades. Obviously, this is one of those three to improve our team, and we're always going to be, aggressive yet disciplined when the time comes, and continue to help us by adding players and adding avenues that we can improve the team. Tonight, obviously, an important step there. A couple things I'm going to read so I don't get in trouble with the league. As part of a deal to be finalized later, the Kings are trading to the Mavericks the draft rights to Olivier Maxence Prosper, the 24th pick. Per league rules, I am not allowed to say anything more. We've also agreed in principle to acquire the draft rights to the 34th pick, Colby Jones. The trade is not yet final, but I can talk about Colby, who was obviously a productive and smart utility player, a defender, a two-way player. Somebody that we're really excited to add to the culture that Mike, myself, and the rest of us are building here. Really a winner. Won almost two-thirds of his games at Xavier. So we're excited to bring him in. Also excited to welcome Jalen Slawson to the Kings. Jalen was the SoCon Player of the Year this year, Defensive Player of the Year, I believe 2 years ago. So excited to bring those two guys into our organization. With that, I'll take questions. Come on, Sean.
Sorry about that. I guess, what can you tell us about just the draft overall? Maybe the vibe in that room, obviously a busy day for you guys, probably on the phone. Just how can you kind of sum up the day with the activity? So
it's it's buzzing, I think, for the most part. And then last year we got right into it. We were just trying to figure out who's going to be there at four. This year we were sitting and waiting, so it was a good feeling, a little slow, and then it just goes crazy, especially in the second round. But the great thing our group does, obviously not just on the evaluation of the players, but all the things that could come up, we're prepared with papers of information, tools. Our group does an incredible job with information across the NBA, which is a huge currency and allows us to move around the board as needed and figure out what's going on. And just to keep a track of the picks and who's got what is a Herculean task. They do a great job. So obviously a lot of long nights, weekends leading up to this to be prepared, but the energy of draft night keeps everybody through. I'm sure they'll sleep well tonight.
Monty, Jalen, fifth year senior, and Colby put in 3 years. What went into those decisions? These guys, they spent a lot of time on the floor, so that means they're going to come in, with a little bit of experience. What went into the decision, to pick up much over the guys?
Really, we're open to anybody who's proven that they can win and help us win. This year happened to be, two guys that have been in college for a few years. But, Jalen obviously had a big win in the tournament. I mentioned some of his awards and a guy who's been able to show it on both ends. And then, Colby is just one of the best two-way players, a winner. And, those are the things that we always look for. And we know what Coach Brown, his staff value, what me and my staff value. And, especially with guys like Colby that we have what our scouts love. We got one of our scouts, Greg Stratton, lives in Cincinnati, calls it the Cincinnati-based scouting region, where I don't know, he can touch, I guess with UCLA and USC going, he can touch, like, I don't even know, 100 of the top schools in driving distance. And Xavier's right in his backyard, and he's seen Colby a lot, and Greg's one of the best scouts in this league, and really cool to that he was able to see this guy a lot. And then our analytics evaluate him, see all the stuff that he does, all the little things that we pick up on. And when those two things overlap, as we've talked about, makes my job easy.
Hey, Monty, I know you can't talk about the 24th pick specifically, but what is the balance of the prep work that you do and the ideas that you have coming into draft night of the direction you want to go versus other teams make moves and make changes that create opportunities on draft night and trying to pounce or take advantage of that?
It's about our group does a great job of having a plan, really a long-term plan, as we talked about. It's not, you know, one thing after another. All these things flow right in to each other, and so we know we have the draft, we have free agency, we have trade. Those are kind of the three prongs that we can do, but trying to balance having that direction with not being too rigid, so we can react to what happens during the draft or in free agency or at the trade deadline, any of those times. So you know, it's a bit of a balance, but our group you know, really does an incredible job of being ready, and we play a lot of those scenarios off of each other leading up to it.
Monty, again, I know you can't get into certain specifics. I won't mention names or anything like that, but it sounds like you may have created some financial flexibility tonight. I just wonder if you can talk about that aspect of this, what your goals were there, and how maybe you might be able to use that flexibility moving forward.
Yeah, we'll continue, obviously, July 1 when free agency kicks off. You know, we'll be able to figure out what our options are. But, you know, really, I think the main thing tonight is that we added two guys to our team that we think can help us, you know, not just on the defensive end, but on the offensive end. But, you know, some things that we'll talk about when that time comes.
Hey, Monty, two questions for you regarding Colby. Just to start, you know, a guy that shot a lot better from three this year than years prior, and not the best free throw numbers. So what gives you confidence that the three-point shooting you saw this year is real with Colby?
It, you know, our scouts do a great job of, and I mentioned Greg and others who do a bunch of intel work, but Colby's work ethic and you know, the person that he is, his character, those are the types of things that we like to see for guys as they improve throughout college, and that they'll continue to improve when they get into our situation. But it's all the other stuff that Colby does too. He's got great touch. The shot improved obviously this year, but that he can get in there and make a play with a pass, an offensive rebound on the offensive end, and then defensively can guard, you know, up and down. You know, probably not a lot of centers, but you know, he's strong, he's big, and you know, he's going to be very versatile on that end as well. But you know, obviously the shooting is a big part of the NBA these days, and we like to see the growth that he's shown.
And how much do you value that versatility that he supplies on both ends, you know, playing on and off the ball on both sides of the floor, and how important is that as a connecting piece?
Yeah, we've got as you know, we got two all NBA guys that we're building around, and so guys that can help them on both ends of the floor. They're going to do, Domas and Fox are going to do a lot of the heavy lifting for us on the offensive end, but guys that can be connecting pieces, guys that can finish plays, guys that can make the intermediate play, the hockey pass, especially with the offense that Coach Brown and Coach Triano have. We want high IQ guys that can come in here and just figure out a way to contribute no matter who they're on the floor with.
Monty, you just mentioned that Domas is presumably one of the guys you're building around. Where do things stand? There's been a lot of discussion, I guess, about a contract extension with him. Just where do things stand on that front with him?
Yeah, Domas is obviously an incredible player, and you know, we want him here long term. And when the appropriate time comes, we'll be talking to him about those ways to keep him here.
And with Colby, Dante DiVincenzo is somebody that onlookers have sort of compared him to. Do you get similar vibes? Is that the type of player that you're looking to acquire? Someone who can add some of those things to your team?
Yeah, I think with Colby, there are a lot of guys, especially as you watch the playoffs, the guys that are versatile, that they can do a lot of different things on the floor because you know, you don't know what's going to be thrown at you. And you know, Colby showed that at Xavier through his 3 years, especially this year as he took on an even bigger role. And so you know, I have no doubt that he'll be able to figure that out at the next level.
Yeah, Monty, how much was tonight about setting yourself up for free agency, for trades and everything else, especially the way that you were able to manipulate sort of your salary cap stuff?
Yeah, I think for us, you know, it's we always value the optionality and flexibility when we can acquire it. We've got, I think, a really this was a great season. You know, for a lot of reasons, and we want to have a long playoff run here and continue to compete. And to do that in today's NBA, you have to be able to build your team out not just in the very near term, but over the course of many years. And so we're always having that balance, right? Well, what can we do to add to the team now, but how does that affect what we can do going forward? So we think you know, what we were able to do tonight and what we've done going back to the deadline in past years will give us a lot of options, not just this summer, but as we get into next year.
Just looking back overall again, the totality of the draft, did this kind of plan out go the way you guys may have planned? Was anything surprising about the way things went tonight?
Always surprises. Phil Jabor, who's our VP of player personnel, who does a great job, but we always try draft night. We got all our scouts in town. We try to have a dinner, and one of the games he has is earlier or later where a guy's going. And without fail, we'll always look back saying, you never know. You know, certainly opened up at some point in this draft. And by the same token, our guys, I think, for the most part, had a decent sense of what may happen. And you know, we were ready to pivot when different things changed, especially when you're picking later in the draft, it's hard enough to predict it for what's going to happen at 24. You got no shot, so you just got to do the best you can, be prepared for those scenarios, and you know, credit to my staff for, you know, knocking it out of the park.
You obviously know much more than us and the fans in terms of what lies ahead for your future after tonight. From what you were able to pull off tonight, is it safe to assume this was a home run, great deal of success as you guys try to plan for what's to come later this summer?
I think I hesitate to say those things because ultimately it's only going to be a home run if we're able to go out next year and produce on the floor. And, you know, eventually we're going to be held to an even higher standard in the playoffs, which is what we want. So that's going to be how we're graded. But I think we're happy with what we're able to do tonight. Now it's on to the next thing and how we can continue to get this team ready to take the next step. And so happy with, you know, the guys that we added, what we're able to do. And, you know, we'll be judged by the wins.
Any plans or ideas of what to do with the two-way contract spots that you're able or willing to share?
The two ways have been, I think, a really great addition. It's I think really good for teams to be able to get guys into their system, and we've done a great job with Stockton, you know, finishing first in the regular season, and you know, winning at that level too, and developing guys. And like I said, we're going to have to build this thing sustainably. We're going to have to find guys on those two ways that graduate. There was, I'm sure, a team in the NBA playoffs this year that people point to that has had success there. We're going to have to continue to follow that path to build out around the really good players that we have. So, you know, we'll see where that shakes out, but those two ways are valuable, and we'll continue to treat them as such.
Monty, any update on Domas and the thumb and whether that required surgery? There was a report today, I think out of Europe, that he was not going to play in FIBA competition this summer. Can you speak to that and just where he's at with the thumb?
I know Domas is working out. A lot of our guys, you know, are already either here in our gym or somewhere else getting their work in. I know Domas obviously, you know, played through that thumb injury. You know, we do expect him to be good to go next year, but not sure exactly where it's going to be at this summer, but I know he's already working on whatever he can.
Are we good, guys?
Monty, your first draft, you're number 12, next draft, number 9, and then number 4. How much different is it to draft 24, and how much different is it when you have a team that was third in the West, and how does that change sort of your mindset going into draft and free agency?
Yeah. It's obviously the pressure and all those things ramp up when you're in the lottery. You know, our group has done an incredible job. The three picks that we've had in the lottery have allowed us to build the team that we had this year. The downside of winning so many games is you got to wait a little longer for your pick, but we've seen some really good players in this league, including, you know, some very notable examples who have been picked where we were picking this year in those areas. And so, we take it as a challenge, and there's a lot of opportunity out there for us to improve the team. And when you have those key centerpieces in place, like we got with Foxy and Domas, Keegan had a great rookie year, Kevin, on and on. It allows us to find guys that fit into that system. And I think with Mike, Jordy, Jay, Doug, all the way down, what they've done with our group, we know what they're looking for, and the players know what to expect. And so it makes our job a little easier, a little focused on who's going to fit in there. And obviously with a lottery pick, it's a little different what you're looking for later in the draft, guys that can come in and help, whether it's right away or develop in Stockton and help us down the road. We're going to need those guys, and we're going to have to continue to do a good job even when we pick later in the draft.
Yeah, Monty, so a lot of buzz around Sasha this summer. I think Jay, Mike, Jordy went out to go watch him. How impressed were you from his performance this summer? And obviously, I think when the draft's over, you guys can start negotiating in that deal. How much of a priority is it for you and your front office to get a deal done?
Yeah, Sasha had a great season. Olympiacos had a great season. They were a fantastic organization and, welcomed us as we came to see him. And, when we get to free agency, we'll have all those free agent conversations. But it was fun to see Sasha and, the great year that him and his team had.
About the obviously the promotion of Anjali, Ranadive, as well as Lindsey Harding at the Stockton level.
Yeah, Lindsey has been here since before I got here and done a fantastic job on both the previous staff and Mike's staff. The guys really respond to her. She's had a big hand in not just our game plans and those things, but in developing our guys, getting to work on the court. Obviously a great basketball player in her own right, as we all know. Really excited for her. I know she's excited for that next step. Big shoes to fill, given what we did. And, for Anjali to come in, Paul Johnson was the GM last year, the executive of the year for Stockton. Anjali is the assistant GM, had a huge hand in that. And, she's ready, and we're excited for her to partner with Lindsey. And, I think we talked about this more in theory when we came in, but we expect to win all up and down the organization, right? We've won in summer league. We've had some good preseasons. We've had good G League seasons. We've had now, some success in the NBA. And so we're going to need to continue that. We expect to win all up and down, and we expect to develop our players that go to Stockton, and it's a huge part of what we do. I think the last thing I'll mention is just Lindsey being a part of Mike's staff and now going to Stockton is something we really value. They have a great relationship, great communication, and that's huge for us as we continue to, build this thing from 1 to 18. All right, thank you guys. Get some sleep. I will say, we got a little one at home, 9 days old, and as anybody who's seen their wife go through it, my wife is an absolute rock star, and on top of that, let me get some rest in the guest house in the hotel this week. So she's a double rock star. But I'm excited to spend some more time with our little ones. So I've gotten enough sleep to get through the day. So. Congratulations.